Day 28. It's your boy OBZ here. Do it to life before life. Do it to you. Do it to 2021. A whole year of breast cancer awareness and personal growth for myself. Hopefully for you too. Getting to jump on 2021. Another week in the books on Sunday. I like to reflect and see just what I accomplished last week. My challenges for last week. Main thing that I was looking at as far as last week was, man, just those strongholds that's just been in my mind. The strongholds is just that I've been trying to take down. And you know, this is November, so this is generosity. One of the nuggets that I got, you know, last week was that I could give my way. Giving and generosity takes down those strongholds. Some of the strongholds may be, talking in front of others or sharing with others. But if I believe that what I'm sharing with others is going to benefit them, and I can convince myself of that, working in that area, then the stronghold that's preventing me from doing that will start to come down. I'm starting to see a glimmer of that. I'm very happy because I got some strongholds that's been there for years and years, and it's starting to kind of come down. I'm seeing that this is a way that I can do it in this 365 days. Man, I'm excited. Still haven't had a chance to go and do my GPS. Their brain is still thinking and trying to figure things out as far as, you know, what my one thing for 2021 is going to be. I know it's personal growth. I know it's completing this challenge for number one. Bringing more awareness to breast cancer for number one. Also personal growth for myself for number one. It's a lot of number ones, right? But he said in the book, it can only be one thing. So on Sundays, what I do, I always read at least one chapter out of my Bible every Sunday before I get out of bed. That's another little nugget that I like to use, because when you wake up, your spirit man is still strong. I mean, we talked about this probably day five or something like that. It's triune being. You got your spirit man, you got your mental man, you got your physical man. And those mental and physical are way more developed than your new spirit man, because you've been born again. You see what I'm saying? So that man is small. So what I do is, when I wake up in the morning before my body fully awakens and my mind fully awakens, I go ahead and pull my phone out. Remember, we're using the tools that we have. We have these cell phones, so we have no excuse. We have all the answers right here in the palm of our hands. No need to go and buy anything. No need to go and do nothing. Remember, I told you this outline, you're going to change this. All this is for free. Because you're already paying for it, so you ain't paying no extra. That's what I'm saying, for free. We're just utilizing what we already have, because we already have enough. And we're going to use that excess in order to share. You see what I'm saying? So this is where we're at. So time I wake up, I don't care if it's, you know, 3 o'clock in the morning. If I can't get back to sleep, I go ahead and pop my phone open, go to my Bible app, which was free. Download that. Make sure you subscribe, support them. I go to my Bible app, and I just read a chapter. I thumb through, stop. Okay, and then I read a chapter. But I read that chapter, and then if I'm still not sleeping, I read another chapter. And then I go ahead and ask my questions for the day. What does this mean? How is this going to help me? How can I achieve this goal? What about this I asked you yesterday? Lord, tell me about this. That's when I go through my questions, because there I'm the closest to God at that point. So that's what I'm doing. I'm going through those questions. I'm reading my Bible. This is all without having to get out of the bed. If I have an idea that pop up, I go straight to the cell phone. Go into my, I got a Word app down there. It was free. Any kind of note-taking app is also free. And you jot those notes down, those ideas in the middle of the night, jot them right down. I know what's going to happen. So your brain's going to come up. This will happen to me. My brain comes up and say, man, look. Man, what are you doing? We need to be sleeping. And the body be like, oh, yeah, man, we need to be sleeping. I ain't going to feel right if I don't get enough sleep. And so you'll spend hours sitting there trying to go back to sleep. It's going to always take me the same amount of time, probably about an hour. to go back to sleep. So I'm saying if I'm gonna be up anyway, it's gonna take me an hour. Go ahead and make it positive. So that's why I go ahead and read. That's why I go ahead and ask those questions. That's why I go ahead and put those notes in, because I'm gonna be up anyway. So you wake up, but your brain and your body gonna try and talk you out of it. And so that's what I'm saying. It's gonna try and talk you out of it, but you gotta stay with it. But that's what we're doing. I'm reminding you, you can't learn this in one night, because the brain and the body's been running the show for years and years. See what I'm saying? So now I'm just a reminder. Like I said, I'm gonna get me a new shirt. I know my new shirt gonna be. My new shirt gonna be Lighthouse. It's just gonna be a lighthouse right there, just to remind me where the rocks are. Just remind me where the shore is, so I don't get so far out into the deep that I can't get back, or I crash myself on a rock. That came out of one of those things was in Stephen Covey's Seven Habits of Highly Effective People. He told a story, right? Beautiful story. He said it was a ship, USS Missouri or something like that. Mighty, mighty ship. Man, you need to listen to it, read it. Mighty, mighty ship. And he said that one of his captains or whatever the crewman name was looking through the periscope. Hey, it's a light in our ceiling. Oh, man, tell him it's the USS Missouri to starboard. Sir, they're still in there. They're still, what? This is the battleship, man. This is the USS Missouri. You tell those people, starboard. Still nothing happened. Sir, it's still there. And he kept doing that. He said, man, what is wrong with these people? They don't know we're a battleship. And then they finally, the light answered. It said, starboard yourself. And the captain said, starboard myself. Man, I could blow them out of the water. He said, this is the USS Missouri. And the guy replied back, this is the lighthouse. Starboard yourself. Boom. The captain had to starboard itself. And the whole thing about that is, say, these truths, sometimes you can crush yourself on these truths if you don't embrace them and understand them and use them. These truths will crush you. Something like that. I may have mixed the whole thing up, but it was like that, right? So I'm going to have to dig in there. I want you to dig in there too. You should have your nice library built up. All free, of course. All free. Don't go out and buy a whole bunch of stuff, right? Hey, your whole library built up. But I like that. I'm gonna get that lighthouse. You know, we just gonna remind each other, you know, and then when we see each other, we be reminded, oh yeah, that's a part of me, you know, that's a part of me right there. You see something that you don't remember, that came out of last week too. If I see something, somebody doing something that I don't like, I say, man, that's a part of me right there doing that. How can I help that part of me overcome that? Without judgment on that person, but that person is exhibiting a part of me. So if I can, you see what I'm saying? So I'm trying to help that. You see what I'm saying? I guess the world is my guinea pig, right? And by me helping them, I help myself. That's a Bible verse. That's from last week. You know, it's all packed on there. He who waters is also watered. I can't water some or wash a car without getting wet myself. You see what I'm saying? Zig Ziglar said, you help enough people get what they want, you'll always get what you want. And that brings me to the verse that I read last night. It was in 2 Corinthians. I don't know. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, maybe 3 or 4. It's all coming back to me now. But he said in there that we get our comfort from the Lord. And we get our comfort from the Lord so we can give comfort to those who can't, don't have the connection. You see what I'm saying? I'm out here in this sun. Hey, I'm feeling fantastic. And I'm going to take this sun and this light, and I'm going to take it back into the house, back into my world, and provide light. That's what we're doing. We provide light. So if you got your health, your mental faculty, and it may be just a few items that you're just feeling upset about, start to think, hey man, I'm in good shape. My mind is working, my body is working. Man, let's turn this thing around. So you got a little light because you're looking at this, right? You got a little light. So we're gonna get that light to be a little bit bigger. Hope you listen to the four agreements. The one thing in the Bible, this is the three ingredients for my recipe. And and a little sprinkle, a little seasonings from some other little places along in there. But this is my recipe, just to do it to life recipe. We're going to do this recipe to our life, to our physical life, mental life, financial life, love life, all life. We're going to do this recipe to it, do his sayings to it from Matthew chapter 7. It's your boy, Obzi. Do it to life. For life, do it to you. Do it to 2021. A whole year breast cancer awareness and personal growth. Boom. I'm out.